Hi everyone, today I want to show you how to install and use the Hunitor, a serial monitor application written by our good friend James. It's probably the best way to interface with the D-Offer V3 as of yet. D-Offer V3 might be a misleading name at this point because it can do so much more than just D-Off, but the only way to control it is through a serial connection. And the Hunitor is a custom application that makes that serial access easier. We are planning more tutorials on individual functions of the D-Offer V3, so if you're interested, be sure to subscribe. If you have a D-Offer V2 device, you can also use the Hunitor to interface with that. However, some features won't work. Now, before we get started, a word from our sponsor. JLC PCB is my personal go-to whenever I need PCBs quickly, for example when prototyping new products. They have a fast turnaround time, good quality, and stunningly low prices. Just $2 for 5 PCBs at 10x10cm or 4x4inches. The order process is simple and fast. There are plenty of options. You can also easily panelize your board and add a solder stencil to your order. Both features I personally love because they make it so much easier to produce products like our Andromeda board. JLC PCB also offers a SMT assembly service with integration to the EasyEDA designer and LCSC parts. If you're interested, check out the link in the description. It would help our channel too. Okay, now to the installation process. One thing to note is that everything shown here is also described in the README of the GitHub repository or on hunitor.com. So if you want to copy paste commands or look up some of the details again later, be sure to head over there. On Windows, it's as easy as to download an .exe file and simply double click to start it. You might get a warning because it's an executable you downloaded from the internet. But of course, everything is open source and you can also compile it yourself relatively easily if you want. For macOS, we recommend using Homebrew. If you don't have it installed, you find a convenient one-liner on their website. Then you have to add our repository to your sources. And after that is done, you can simply run brew install Hunitor. To start the program, simply type Hunitor in a terminal. For Linux, there are two convenient installation methods depending on your distribution. If you use Ubuntu or similar, you can use snap. So sudo snap install hunitor --etc/--devmode, that's for the permissions. For, by the way, I use Arch users, you can run the command yay -S hunitor. To start a program, simply type sudo hunitor in a terminal. Alternatively, you can also compile Hunitor yourself. That way you won't even have to trust our compiled binaries or rely on the mentioned packet managers. Since it's written in Rust, you have to install Rustup. You might need to install dependency tools too, but you can find all of that in our README. But if you have Rust installed, you can just download or git clone our repository and run cargo run to simply start the Hunitor. Or cargo build --release to compile a binary file for your system. Using the Hunitor once it's installed and running is pretty easy. It greets you with a selection of serial ports and you simply type the port name or its ID. If you're unsure which port is the one of your D-Offer, you can just reconnect it because the Hunitor will recognize the new port and automatically connect to it. Once connected, you can type help or help -s to get a list of available commands. You can also use start for a guided step-by-step command builder or use the master command chicken to get the most beautiful ASCII chicken you've ever seen. On some Linux systems, you might need to give your user permission to access the serial ports. Arduino on Linux users might have encountered this before. Luckily, there's an easy command to fix that, which you can see here. If no serial port is recognized when you plug in your D-Offer, it can have multiple reasons. It could be a faulty or power-only USB cable. So try changing that. Maybe try changing the USB port as well if there's an issue with the port. Sometimes a USB hub can also be the issue, but it could also be just a driver issue. We link drivers in the README as well. Our Andromeda board uses the FTDI chip, That's the third link. But we link the other two common serial chip drivers as well for anyone that builds their own deoffer. Now, of course, there are alternatives. The Hunitor is made specifically for the deoffer in mind, having colored output, pre-configured settings, so you don't have to mess with any of that, and basically plug and play, you know? And it's also cross-platform. But obviously, there are plenty of other good serial terminals out there, probably the easiest being the Arduino Serial Monitor. But other popular serial tools include Screen, Minicom, or PuTTY. And we are also working on a browser-based tool which is aimed to be very user-friendly. Be sure to subscribe to be notified about that. But keep in mind that it won't replace the Hunitor, as the Hunitor is a command-line application and that still has its use cases, even if we have a more user-friendly way of interfacing with our products. Now, if you're interested in the deoffer V3, we sell our Andromeda dev port at spacehound.com, which comes pre-flashed with the deoffer V3. We offer EU-wide free shipping, and if you live in the US, you can also get one at hackerinterchange.com. There's also a Udemy class, which teaches you about the deoffer V3, but you can also subscribe to our YouTube channel to see upcoming tutorials. So that's it for this video. Thanks for watching, and have a nice day.